Hi everyone, my name is Kostas Kolias. I'm a research scientist in the Geo Algorithms group at Google Research. So this is my talk for the ACM 6 Special Conference on Advances in Geographic Information Systems. This is for the paper titled Weighted Stackelberg Algorithms for Road Traffic Optimization. So let me pull up my slides. So this is a joint work with other members of the Geo Algorithms group, specifically Arun, Lisa Srinivas, and Ali. So in this work, we study the problem of managing road traffic, specifically optimizing the aggregate travel time of all vehicles in the road network. This is a problem that impacts billions of people living in urban areas across the world. And this is a problem for which the emergence and popularity of routing platforms such as Google Maps offers a new tool. This is a very fundamental problem. It has been studied in the scientific literature for, under different models, and the most prominent of which is the wardrobe model of traffic, where the road network is modeled as a graph and the vehicle traffic on it as a network flow. The edges of the graph model road segments, and they have flow-dependent delay functions, which typically are assumed to be continuous, increasing, and convex. Now, under this model, it is known that the solution that is reached by selfish drivers, the ones who seek to optimize their individual travel time, is not necessarily aligned with the with what is optimal for the road network. Think of this simple example we have here on this slide. We only have two nodes, the origin node S and the destination node T. There is a unit of flow traffic that wants to go from S to T. There are two options to do that. There is the top path, the top link, which has a congestion-dependent delay. Specifically, the delay is equal to the fraction of the traffic that picks the top link. If half of the traffic goes there, let's say that they will have half an hour of delay. If all of the traffic goes there, they will have 1 hour of delay. The second option is the bottom link, which we can think of as a large and long highway. The delay there is not congestion-dependent. It's a fixed 1 hour, independent of the amount of flow that will go through that link. Now, if you're a selfish driver in this setting, you will always pick the top link. The top link will never be worse than the bottom link. If everybody goes top, they will be the same. If there's at least one driver that picks the bottom link, the top one will be slightly better. In this regard, the selfish solution, the equilibrium solution as it is termed, is the red one that we see here on the slide. All the flow, the whole unit goes on the top, and they experience a 1 hour delay because of that. Now, suppose that we had the power to dictate paths to the flow, and we would split them half on the top and half on the bottom. What would happen in this case is that the half of the flow that goes on the bottom will experience the fixed 1 hour delay, but the other half will experience a half hour delay for an average of 3/4. Now, understanding this inefficiency that is induced by selfish behavior has been studied a lot. Theoretical results show that in the worst case, we can have a 33% increase on the total travel time when the delay functions are linear. When the delay functions become higher order polynomials, such as quartic, we can get up to 115% or increase. However, these are pessimistic guarantees. They are worst case analysis. Data studies have shown that the actual inefficiency in real cities in the world is somewhere between 8 and 10%, which is a number that we also verify in this work. Now, this is in terms of understanding, but what can we do in terms of intervention? Suppose we had access to an alpha fraction of the traffic in the network, and we were able to dictate the routes that this alpha fraction would follow. What would we do in the small example that we saw before? We would start pushing traffic on the bottom link. We would push the whole fraction that we were able to, that we have access to, up until this 0.5, which is exactly when we recover the optimal solution. Now, if we do the math, what we get as the induced average travel time is what we see here in the plot. As on the x-axis, the penetration rate, which is this parameter alpha, increases from 0 to 1, then the aggregate delay, the cost on the y-axis, starts off with its worst value, which is the unit. It starts improving until eventually, when we have a penetration rate of half, we hit the optimal of 3/4 or 0.75. Now, this setting where we're able to control a fraction of the flow and then the remaining flow responds with shortest paths or fastest paths is the Stackelberg routing problem. Algorithms for the Stackelberg routing problem have been studied before in the literature. They mostly follow this two-stage approach, where first you will compute the optimal traffic assignment, assuming that you have control over the whole flow. This can be done with a convex program. After this is done, you allocate the Stackelberg flow, the one that you have access to, using one of the following strategies. Either use the highest delay routes, which recovers the largest latency first, or LLF algorithm. You can use the lowest delay routes for SLF, or you can route proportionally to the optimal flow, in which case you recover the scale algorithm. Now, this setting has many similarities to online routing platforms, like the Google Maps example I mentioned before. Like these platforms have access to a fraction of the flow, and maybe they can use it to improve the traffic for the whole network, including users and non-users. However, there are some differences between the online routing platform setting and the standard Stackelberg model. The first one is that an online platform does not dictate paths. It recommends paths to the users, which they might follow, but might also not follow. Another thing is that a platform cares about its users. If we look closely at the example that I mentioned before, the traffic that we're pushing at the bottom link in the optimal solution has a 1 hour delay, whereas the remaining traffic has half an hour delay. We're giving twice the cost to the users of the platform and what is experienced by everyone else in their own network. So this is something that you don't want to do. You want to provide good service to your clients. And also, if you give them paths that are so bad compared to whatever else is available in the road network, people will stop following your recommendations. They will, the whole effort will just fail. So the overarching question that we're studying here is, can we design Stackelberg routing algorithms that do improve the total delay in the network, like the original algorithms do, but they also respect the cost of the users of the platform? So our approach is to focus on two quantities and the interplay between the two. So we look at what is the average percentage increase of user costs over fastest paths in the network? What is the overall travel time, which is the thing that we're trying to optimize in the end? And what is the trade-off between the two? To get good algorithms for this problem, we define a variant of the Stackelberg routing problem, which we call the weighted Stackelberg routing problem. In the weighted Stackelberg routing problem, again, we're asked to route a user flow, or Stackelberg flow as it's called, so that once the induced selfish flow of non-user comes into the of non-users comes into the network, we will minimize the total user travel time plus beta times the total non-user travel time, where beta is a parameter that is less than one, meaning that we slightly discount the costs of non-users so that we can bring the experience of users closer to the fastest paths in the network. Summary of the results that we get, right? In terms of analytical results of mathematical proofs, we show that the weighted Stackelberg routing problem can be solved within a constant factor approximation algorithm. On the experimental side, we focus on real road networks. We go to four metro areas which have different topological properties, which are New York, San Francisco, Bay Area, Delhi, and Bangalore. And we show that our algorithms actually significantly improve the experience of platform users with a very small loss in terms of the total travel time compared to the original Stackelberg algorithms. Our algorithms focus again on a two-stage approach. We first compute an approximate solution for the weighted objective. Unfortunately, the weighted objective is not convex, so we cannot compute the optimal solution for it. But to get an approximate solution, one can use integer programming, LP rounding, local search, or solving for the unweighted objective and using the induced solution. We have tried all these things in our algorithms. And then stage two, again, allocates the user flow, the Stackelberg flow, using the solution of stage one, again, using one of the strategies that we saw before, the largest latency first, shortest latency first, scaling the solution, and so on. So our theoretical result is shown here in this theorem. We saw that for linear delay functions, the approximation ratio that we can achieve is this complicated expression here. As an example, if you plug in values to alpha of 1/4, meaning we have access to 25% of the traffic, and beta is 1/2, meaning we scale the cost of non-users by 2. We make it smaller by a factor 2. The upper bound that we get on the approximation ratio is 9.33. So I don't have time to go into the details of the proofs. Our analysis uses price of anarchy smoothness technique, and you can read more about it in the paper. Now, in terms of experimental results, looking at a real graph with realistic demands, for example, in New York City, this plot here shows on the x-axis how much worse are things for the users of the platform? How much increase do we give them over the fastest path? Whereas the y-axis shows the percentage improvement in the total delay. The red, blue, and yellow dots represent original algorithms, the ones that come from prior work, that actually only seek to optimize the total travel time. The green dots are runs of our algorithm, which we call beta direct, for different values of parameter beta. So here, a good point is to the left and high up. What we see here is that we can bring things significantly to the left by dropping only slightly in terms of the total cost with when compared to the original algorithms. The top image shows what happens when we have a penetration rate of 0.2, which means we have access to 20% of the traffic in the network. The bottom image shows more groups for 40%, 60%, and 80%. So here you can pick pretty much your favorite green dot and get the trade-off between how much you make things worse for your users and how much you improve the total travel time. So to summarize, in this work, we define the weighted Stackelberg routing problem. We design algorithms with provable guarantees and conduct the first experimental evaluation for Stackelberg algorithms, both original and our work, using real data. There's future work that can be done in this setting. We believe that it's an interesting question to see how you can define Stackelberg algorithms with guarantees for the Stackelberg flow, for the user flow. And we believe that an interesting open question is how can you provide worst case guarantees rather than average case guarantees that we provide here, and look at epsilon, Nash equilibria, and so on. So with that, thank you for following the talk, and please read our paper for more.